So we're asked, is the expression x minus 3, is this a factor of this fourth degree polynomial? And you could solve this by doing algebraic long division, by taking all of this business and dividing it by x minus 3, and figuring out if you have a remainder. If you do end up with a remainder, then this is not a factor of this. But if you don't have a remainder, then that means that this divides fully into this right over here without a remainder, which means it is a factor. So if the remainder is equal to 0, if and only if it's a factor. It is a factor. And we know a very fast way of calculating the remainder of when you take some polynomial and you divide it by a first degree expression like this. I guess you could say when you divide it by a first degree polynomial like this. The polynomial remainder theorem. The polynomial remainder theorem tells us that if we take some, some polynomial, p of x, and we were to divide it by some x minus a, then the remainder is just going to be equal to our polynomial evaluated at a. So let's just see what's a in this case. Well, in this case, our a is positive 3. So let's just evaluate our polynomial at x equals 3. If what we get is equal to 0, that means our remainder is 0, and that means that x minus 3 is a factor. If we get some other remainder, that means, well, we have a non-zero remainder, and this isn't a factor. So let's try it out. So we're going to have, so I'm just going to do it, I'll do it all in magenta. It might be a little computationally intensive. So it's going to be 2 times 3 to the 4th power, 3 to the 4th, 3 to the 3rd, is 81. 81 minus 11, yeah, this is going to get a little computationally intensive, but let's see if we can power through it. 11 times 27, I probably should have picked a simpler example, but let's just keep going. Plus 15 times 9, plus 4 times 3 is 12, minus 12, so lucky for us, at least those last two terms cancel out. And so this is going to be the rest from here is arithmetic. 2 times 81 is 162. Now let's think about what 27 times 11 is. So let's see, 27 times 10 is going to be 270. 270 plus another 27 is minus 297. 297, did I do that? Yeah, 270. So 27 times 10 is 270 plus 27, 297, yep, that's right. And then we have, I'm prone to make careless errors here. See, 90 plus 45 is 135, so plus 135. And let's see, if I were to take 162 and 135, that's going to give me 297 minus 297 minus 200, let me do that green color, minus 297. And we do indeed equal 0. So the remainder, if I were to divide this by this, is equal to 0. So x minus 3 is indeed a factor of all of this business.